And as I said, we reviewed the documents that appear to show the payments you revealed earlier today. We haven't independently verified them. But the fact that AT&T has now come out saying that the documents, at least relating to AT&T, are correct, obviously bolsters the authenticity of the documents. I know you're not going to say what your information is based on, but you are obviously very confident in the information that you released earlier.
100%, Anderson. 100% confident. We would not have released this if we were not 100% confident in the accuracy of the information. I believe right before we went live, the New York Times issued an article where they verify the accuracy of what we've released based on their independent review of other documents. There's no question that this is accurate. It took a lot of work. We've been working on this for some time. We've been in this case for a number of months. We've been spending a lot of time on the case. We've got a whole team of individuals that are working on the case back in California, and we're highly confident in the information we released.
Let's begin with the $500,000 paid to Michael Cohen's LLC from this company, Columbus Nova, which is this U.S. company that's affiliated with a Russian company owned by this oligarch with ties to Putin. Is it clear to you why this company would have paid Michael Cohen after the election payments up to $500,000?
It's not clear to us yet, but what we do know is that there was about $500,000 worth of payments that took place between January of 2017, so this is after the election that occurred in November 2016, and then up through approximately August of 2017. So about an eight-month time period of payments totaling approximately $500,000. We have yet to hear an explanation from Michael Cohen as to why the personal attorney to the President of the United States, who at the time, at least for a portion of that time, was employed by the Trump Organization, would be accepting payments from a Russian oligarch to the tune of $500,000.
Now, we should point out that the attorney for the American company, Columbus Nova, which is an affiliate of this Russian company, they say that the company made the payment, that this Russian oligarch, Vekselberg, did not have any involvement with the transaction or any involvement with the decision to hire Michael Cohen. Do you have evidence to the contrary?
We do have evidence to the contrary, and also you have the CEO, Mr. Intratar, who's the cousin of the Russian oligarch, right, who is also Russian, obviously, Mr. Intratar is. And look, what's the explanation for the $500,000 worth of payments? I mean, Michael Cohen should not have been accepting money, especially under the circumstances at this time, from anyone with Russian ties, quite frankly.
This American company, they gave money for the inauguration funds. They also gave money, I believe, to the RNC and to for some campaign stuff, all of which is legal. At the very least, there may be no nefarious reason here at all that this company would have given $500,000 to Michael Cohen. They could have been hiring him for any number of consulting work.
For what? For his legal skill and acumen? I doubt that. But
well, I mean, you know, he does have the ear of the president, so a company might want. But at the very least, it is moronic for Michael Cohen, who is representing the president of the United States, to be publicly seen as accepting money from a company which has such deep ties to a Russian company with ties to Vladimir Putin.
Anderson, there's no question about that, but let's back up a minute. You said he may have the ear of the president. Michael Cohen should not be selling access to the president of the United States. I mean, this is a big deal.
Do you believe that is what may have happened here?
Well, from the series of payments, and of course there's a lot of talk about the revelation in our report about the payments made by the oligarch or through the U.S. entity of the oligarch, but there's also other payments that have been disclosed. You referenced a couple of them, AT&T, Novartis. There's others disclosed within the report. And it appears that this may be your typical pay-to-play type scenario where you have someone close to a politician, in this case close to the President of the United States, which is highly unusual, selling access, potential access, to the President of the United States. I don't believe that Michael Cohen is registered as a lobbyist. I don't believe that he's registered as he should be in order to represent any foreign agents or foreign interests. I mean, this is a big deal. I mean, he had to have been receiving this money for something, and it's unclear as to what the excuse is as to why he was receiving this money. And let us remember this. Up until at least April of this year, Michael Cohen continued to serve as the personal attorney to the President of the United States. We saw the President the first week of April on Air Force One refer to Michael Cohen as his attorney in the present sense. You have to speak to Michael. He is my attorney, something along those lines.
You've also said now that the this $500,000 paid from this U.S. affiliate of a Russian company, which you believe ultimately was sent over by this Russian oligarch or ordered by Vekselberg, it was received, I believe, some 75 days after the payment was made to your client, Stormy Daniels. You said you haven't said that this was repaying Michael Cohen for that payment, but you said that this did essentially replenish the Essential Consultants account. Are you making a connection between this payment and the payment made to Stormy Daniels? Do you believe that this was some sort of repayment of Michael to Michael Cohen? Or is this just, it was 75 days after, it's the first money that came in and it replenished the coffers?
Well, here's what, and this is what I said in the tweet. I think I was very clear that it may in fact constitute the repayment of the $130,000. We don't know yet, but what we do know is that the payment to my client was paid on October 27th, 2016. And the first payment from the Russian oligarch through the U.S. entity occurred in January of 2017. We're not aware of any other deposits that came in during that interim time period. Now, there may have been other deposits, but we're not aware of any. And it appears from what Rudy Giuliani has said most recently, although that is a never-ending circle as it relates to what Mr. Giuliani may or may not say on any given day about this, because no one can really figure out the truth, at least at the White House, relating to what happened. According to Mr. Giuliani, the president's reimbursement scheme of this $130,000, the reimbursement scheme relating to the retainer invoices, the law firm retainer invoices, didn't start until much after this.
Do you have any evidence that any of these companies that were giving money into this account were aware that this was the same account used to pay off Stormy Daniels? Because I would imagine any legitimate company or corporation would be very concerned that the money they are paying to this man, Michael Cohen, for whatever services he is allegedly rendering or offering, that it's going to the same account that's being used to do hush agreements.
We don't know if they knew or they did not know, but here's what we do know for certain. Essential Consultants was formed approximately 2 weeks before the payment to my client of $130,000, okay? There's no question in my view that the purpose of the formation of that entity was to further shield that payment from scrutiny by not having Michael Cohen's name directly on it or Donald Trump. There's no question about that in my view. Secondly, the bank account that was set up for the routing of this money, this $130,000, was set up in the name of Essential Consultants, LLC. And in connection with that, and I think that I raised this some time ago on your show, we talked about potential charges that could be brought against Michael Cohen depending on his financial activity or the activity that occurred at the bank. And I think that I referenced on your show the KYC process, which is know your client. And I think I referenced the fact that when they went to establish this account for the LLC, the bank would have asked Michael Cohen questions about what its purpose was, what the expected transaction flow was, et cetera. And we detail in the report now specific information that Michael Cohen gave to the bank when this account was opened, which has proven to be absolutely false.
But a person can change the nature of their business, can't they not?
I mean, they can change the nature of their business, but the nature of this business was never, from all indications, real estate consulting or anything else that Michael Cohen told the bank.
The as we said, there are other companies that gave money. We talked about AT&T. This company, according to your report, the pharmaceutical company Novartis paid Michael Cohen $399,920 in four separate payments in late 2017 into 2018. Do you know why these payments were made?
No, although what we do know is that the dinner that the president took a dinner with the CEO of Novartis shortly after these payments.
I think it was at Davos or before his speech at Davos.
I believe that's correct. I believe that's what the report states. And what's interesting about those payments, frankly, is the amount of those payments. They appear to be made in sums that are meant to avoid detection of some sort.
$99,000 payments below the $100,000 mark.
Right. Each of the payments are within a very small amount of being a round number. So it looks like they were purposely structured in that way to avoid detection or for some reporting, to avoid some reporting requirement.
I want to read the statement from that Columbus Nova has put out, which is the American arm of this the affiliate of a Russian company. They say after the inauguration, the firm hired Michael Cohen as a business consultant regarding potential sources of capital and potential investments in real estate and other ventures. Reports today that Victor Vekselberg used Columbus Nova as a conduit for payments to Michael Cohen are false. Neither Victor Vekselberg nor anyone else other than Columbus Nova's owners were involved in the decision to hire Cohen or provided funding for his engagement. And that's from Richard Owens, the attorney for Columbus Nova.
Well, Columbus Nova is owned by 100%, to the best of my knowledge, is owned by this Russian national firm, number one.
They say it's a purely American company. It's an American CEO, American board.
Well, look. Mr. Intratar, the CEO, was the cousin of the Russian oligarch, okay? That's A. B, my understanding is it's 100% owned subsidiary of the Russian entity. C, of all the people that could be hired for consulting advice on real estate and the like here in New York or elsewhere, and there's a lot of real estate here in New York, there's a lot of real estate consultants. They just happen to hire the personal attorney to the President of the United States who takes $500,000 during this time period, at the same time period where the President is under intense scrutiny relating to his ties to Russia.
That's what I don't understand.
No, it just makes, well, you don't understand it, I don't understand it, and anybody with any common sense in America shouldn't understand it. And look, there's a very easy solution to all of this, all right? And I'm going to call for it tonight. Michael Cohen should turn over all of his bank records from this account for Essential Consultants from its inception and through today. Just release them. If there's nothing to hide, he should release the bank records, and I'm sure that it will all be sorted out and everyone will come to the conclusion that there's nothing untoward or improper here. I guarantee you that is not what would happen if these bank records were released. Additional questions would result because this doesn't pass the smell test.
The government would also have information on this that if they wanted to make public, they could make public, wouldn't they?
You're absolutely right, and we have called for the release of the suspicious activity report or reports relating to this account. We wrote a letter to the Treasury Secretary. We demanded their release or its release. He did not respond. We have tried to make this a front and center issue without great success. And hopefully at this point, now with the release of this information, there will be a call for the release of this information, the suspicious activity report or reports relating to this account, so the American people can see exactly what happened here and whether additional Russian money was taken, and in addition, where the money went. Did all the money go to Michael Cohen? Did some of it go to the Trump Organization? Did some of it go to the president? Because if additional monies were received in a pay-to-play type scheme, and if those monies made their way either directly or indirectly to the president, well, then we've got a whole different ball.
But wait a minute, you're raising the specter that Michael Cohen is receiving money to get access to the president of the United States, and that the president might be receiving some of that money.
I'm stating that that is certainly a possibility because we don't know where all of this money went, and we need to get to the bottom of it. The American people deserve to know where this money went.
We're going to take a quick break. We're going to have more with Michael after this break. We'll also get the latest in the breaking news tonight that the Mueller team has questioned a Russian oligarch about hundreds of thousands of dollars in payments to Michael Cohen, which we've been talking about, and the latest in the primary races tonight in four states, including the West Virginia race, where a candidate has used racial slurs in his own campaign ads, a candidate who served time in prison and has described himself as Trumpier than Trump. Well, when early on, when you first came on, the very fact that it was so easy to trace Essential Consultants to Michael Cohen is because Michael Cohen did not do a good job of covering his tracks when he set this company up.
Right. He signed as the incorporator on the papers, which is absurd if you're trying to actually shield your involvement with a particular entity. But, I want to touch on some of the reporting we just heard about. Anderson, first of all, AT&T states that they paid $200,000 to better understand the administration.
To get insights.
To get insights. I guess that's why the vast majority of American people can't get honesty and insights, because they don't have $200,000 to pay Michael Cohen to get those insights. You shouldn't have to pay $200,000 to get insights into the administration. I mean, we all know what that really means. So that's first of all. Second of all, it's interesting that AT&T comes out and they issue their statement that they paid $200,000 for insights into the administration. At the same time, you have the entity tied to the oligarch stating that they weren't purchasing access or insights into the administration. They were purchasing real estate consulting services. It's very odd to me.
And business opportunities, I think they said,
and capital opportunities, right. Or business opportunities. Okay, those are very different things. I doubt that Michael Cohen is a one-stop shop for all of these services. This guy's like a Renaissance man. He's a lawyer. He's a business consultant. He's a real estate consultant. He's an administration insight consultant. I mean, what is there anything this man can't do?
I mean, if you are looking for some form of expertise from Michael Cohen, understanding of President Trump, access to President Trump, that would seem to be his biggest calling card of the last several years.
Well, that actually would seem to be his only calling card, legitimate calling card of the last several years. But look, he shouldn't be selling access to the president of the United States, to the people's president. I mean, that's Michael Cohen should not be selling that access. And again, if he's selling that access, it begs the question as to where this money went once it made its way into the account.
There was this payment, $187,500 from Elliot Broidy, and Cohen had said he was involved in a hush agreement for an alleged affair that Broidy allegedly had that involved a pregnancy as well. But it's interesting that he's paying Cohen. I don't know if that's for services rendered. And also these transactions from others, some of them for one account to another, but some of these seem to go back and forth and kind of curve around themselves.
This $187,500 to Michael Cohen, in my view, is very suspicious. As someone that has represented parties on both sides of settlement agreements, sometimes I represent plaintiffs and sometimes I represent defendants. I've got a lot of experience in this, okay? Normally, when you represent a defendant or a potential defendant, which is what Michael Cohen has claimed happened as it relates to this Broidy-type settlement, you would be paid on an hourly basis. So however much time you would spend negotiating that deal, you would be paid whatever your hourly rate is, times however many hours it is. In this case, you would not expect Michael Cohen to have spent a considerable amount of time negotiating that deal if it in fact happened as everyone says. You would expect Michael Cohen to potentially bill $10,000 or $20,000 or maybe $25,000 for his work on behalf of Mr. Broidy. Certainly not $187,500, which is a round number. And it's inexplicable to me as to why Mr. Broidy, over a period of a number of months, would be making regular level payments to Michael Cohen in connection with that. It doesn't make any sense.
What is next for you in all this? I mean, do you have a clear next step? You put this stuff out here. I guess the ripple effects, you don't know where it ends up.
Correct. We don't know what the ripple effects are, but we've shown a lot of flexibility and we've been malleable as it relates to reacting to things in the case. We're going to continue to do that. We certainly have next steps planned out. The timing of those, it's a very fluid situation, as you might imagine. We're going to see what the reaction is from the other side. I mean, I hope the president goes on Fox and Friends tomorrow, and then I hope that Rudy Giuliani makes the rounds on Fox as well. And you know, that'll I'm sure provide a lot of fodder for us in the coming week.
I assume or is it fair to assume, given our reporting that Special Counsel Mueller talked to the Russian oligarch about hundreds of thousands of dollars in payments to Michael Cohen, that Mr. Mueller has all this information or close to this information that you released earlier?
We don't know what Mr. Mueller has or what he does not have. I know that his competence level is extremely high. He's an expert prosecutor. He's an exceptional attorney. I mean, this is no Rudy Giuliani that we're dealing with here. So we have a lot of confidence in his ability and the ability of his team, as well as the team that's been assembled from the Southern District of New York, which are some of the finest prosecutors in the United States.
Do you expect Michael Cohen to come forward and say anything about this? I mean, he's under criminal investigation. It's highly unlikely that he would make some sort of a comment.
Well, I think he made a comment either yesterday or the day before by way of Twitter. He took exception to, I think, the New York Times article, which I was amazed at. I had to read it 3 or 4 times to make sure it was actually him that had posted this, because I thought it was so stupid. But, who knows with this guy? I mean, who knows with him? Rudy Giuliani, we could see any number of things. But look, they should just release the bank records. They should release the bank records, and the American people should demand the release of these suspicious activity reports that are held by the Treasury Department. So the American people can get all the information.
The Treasury Department has them. They could do that.
They could absolutely. They could do it tonight. There's no issue. They could publish the SARs. There's no reason why they shouldn't publish the SARs. They should publish them for the American people and let the American people look at the facts and the evidence. And look, Anderson, if there's nothing nefarious here, and if it was all above board and it was all legit, and I don't believe it was for a moment, I don't think that's true, but let's assume that it is, then they should want to release this information. Rudy Giuliani should actually tell the president, release the information so that we can be over with this thing.
Why would Michael Cohen create this entity, Essential Consultants, with the purpose immediately of, at least the first thing it seemed to have done was pay off Stormy Daniels 11 days before the election? But then why would he use that same entity to collect other monies from, you know, legitimate companies in many cases?
I have no idea.
I mean, but just from a business standpoint, you could easily have, I mean, there's other LLCs you could have, if you're doing legitimate work, you set up a shingle and you want people to know that you're working for AT&T or for some of these other companies.
Yeah, I don't know of any publicity that he attempted to generate, or, you know, it appears as if he didn't really want this known. But again, I don't understand. In November, December of 2016, Michael Cohen does not appear to have had any of these clients like Novartis or AT&T or the Russian oligarch run entity. These appear not to have been his clients in 2016. It was only after the president, or Donald Trump, was elected president in late 2016 that all of a sudden Michael Cohen, I guess on election night, Michael Cohen became an expert in business consulting, real estate consulting, capital investment, and insights into the administration. And all of a sudden, the guy's paid millions of dollars.
I mean, it is the kind of thing that lobbyists are paid a lot of money for. They're paid for access. And that's, I mean, Michael Cohen is not, they're registered.
No, they register and they have to disclose things, and there's rules and regulations. And look, let us not forget that Mr. Trump, when he ran for president, he said he was going to drain the swamp, wasn't going to take any money, there wasn't going to be any of these high-powered lobbyists. I mean, everyone remembers the rhetoric and what they were said. Meanwhile, the guy's right-hand attorney, who had an office next to his office in Trump Tower, meanwhile, we find out that immediately after the election, he's got his hand out and he's accepting all of this money.
Just finally, you tweeted that you're just getting started. Is that hyperbole? Do you have more information? And if so, why not just release it now?
Well, look, if anybody's been paying attention for the last 8-9 weeks, they know that there's not a lot of hyperbole. We make a lot of statements, but we back them up, and then some. We do not overpromise and underdeliver. We underpromise and overdeliver, and that's exactly what we're going to continue to do. There are more bombshells coming. There's more evidence. There's more information. And I have to tell you this. I'm going to touch on this, okay? There's been a lot of criticism lately about, not a lot, there's been some criticism about how our media strategy and how often I'm on CNN and how often I've been on your show and other networks, et cetera, okay? It's all a bunch of nonsense, because here's the bottom line, Anderson. It's working, okay? It's working in spades. And one of the reasons and one of the ways that it's working is because we're so out front on this, people send us information. People want to help our cause. People contact us with information.
When you talk about your cause, what is your cause? What's the end
goal? Our cause right now is having the NDA invalidated. For Stormy Daniels. Holding Michael Cohen responsible for his defamatory statements, holding Mr. Trump responsible for his defamatory statements, and ultimately having all the information relating to this account, the LLC, and the payment to my client laid out for the American people so they can decide what to do.
Michael Avenatti, thanks very much.
Thank you.
Appreciate it. Just had more reaction on that payment to...